see what a virus is. There is a nucleic acid core, DNA or RNA, which is surrounded by a glycoprotein capsid, which may be protein or glycoprotein. When a virus infects a cell, what happens is, what is the mechanism? It attaches to the cell surface, gets entry into the cell. There is uncoating of the viral particles. The viral genome integrates with the host nucleus. And host nucleus, instead of producing its own DNA, it also starts replicating the viral DNA. And this viral DNA persists in the cell in the form of what we see as inclusion bodies. Now, since the host is not manufacturing its own DNA, the functioning of the cell is lost and there may be cytopathic effects or some other changes which occur in the cells. So the various viruses have following sequelae which you will find in the different diseases we study later. The infection caused by the virus is primary when there are no antibodies, or it's usually an acute infection. After acute infection, the viruses may remain latent and they may be reactivated by unfavorable conditions of the host and can lead to a secondary infection. Some of the viruses, they remain persistent and the disease persists for years. That is what we see in the HIV infections and hepatitis B infection. Whereas in some cases, there may be transformation, there may be proliferation, they have a proliferative effect and they can lead to the development of some malignancies. Now, this is how the viral diseases can be classified. The viral lesions of the oral mucosa, viral infections involving salivary glands, and viral infections posing a serious risk to the health personnel. Now, which involve the oral mucosa, they can be again categorized according to the disease they produce. They can be vesicular lesions, they can be exophytic lesions, and hemorrhagic fevers with oral symptoms and diverse oral lesions. This is the human herpes virus. The HSV-1 causes primary gingivostomatitis and recurrent herpetic labialis. It also causes varicella zoster virus. It includes Epstein-Barr virus, which can cause various diseases. And this is how we have up to HHV-8. Now, what happens in the herpes virus? It is a dermatotropic virus. The virus has a primary infection. When we say herpes virus, we mean here the herpes simplex and varicella zoster virus. So both of them, they have a primary infection. After the primary infection, they remain latent in the nerves, ganglions, and they are reactivated to produce the recurrent infection. So this is seen in herpes simplex as well as in herpes zoster infection. Now what happens in herpes primary herpetic infection? As the name says, it is acute herpetic gingivostomatitis. So it is characterized by gingivitis and stomatitis along with the presentation of vesicles, ulcers, vesicles rupture, and they have an erythematous halo and they heal by themselves without any scarring. Now, these are the lesions of gingivostomatitis. This is stomatitis which is seen here and it's seen all over on the mucosa. The reactivation of the latent virus can take place, which can be triggered by a variety of factors that impair the host defense. It may be trauma, surgery, fatigue, stress, allergy, nerve sections, fever, exposure to ultraviolet rays. So, reactivation of the virus leads to the herpes labialis. It's called as herpes labialis because often the lesions, they present on the skin of the lip or mucocutaneous junction, and it's called as fever blisters. They are also vesicles which can rupture and form the ulcerations or dry crust. Intraorally also, it manifests in the form of vesicles. But here, the vesicles refer a site of the mucosa which is tightly bound to the periosteum, that is the palatal and the gingival mucosa. So, what is the histology of these lesions? Histologically, it shows intraepithelial vesicles because it affects the epithelial cells. There is a cytopathic effect and that is why there is collection of edema fluid which causes intraepithelial vesicles. What do you see in this vesicles along with the vascular fluid? It is the acantholytic cells, the cells which are undergoing ballooning degeneration because the viral particles are replicating in them. And these replicating viral particles, they can be seen as inclusion bodies, that is the intranuclear inclusion bodies here, which are called as Lipschitz bodies. And these cells are the Zhang cells, which are seen in a Zhang's test. The treatment is symptomatic relief and use of antiviral agents, that is acyclovir, vidarabine. The lesions which are associated with HSV infection are erythema multiforme and Bell's palsy. These are the extracutaneous, these are the extraoral manifestations of herpes. The varicella zoster virus, another virus of herpes, grow. It also produces a primary infection which is called as varicella or chickenpox. And the recurrent infection is called as herpes zoster infection or shingles. The chickenpox is associated with the prodromal syndromes of intense pleuritic exanthema. The rash begins in the form of macules, they convert into papules, vesicles, and finally they rupture and form the crusts on the skin. Intraorally also similar lesions are seen. Now this virus, after infection, the disease terminates it on itself. The viruses, they remain dormant in the dorsal root ganglions and they are activated by certain factors which reduce the host resistance. It is the immunosuppression, the HIV infection, exposure to radiation, presence of any malignancies in the old age, alcohol abuse, stress and dental manipulations are some of the factors which may lead to the reactivation of the virus. And after reactivation, the virus appears to form the lesions along the distribution of the nerve course. So unilaterally, the lesions are seen along the distribution of the nerve course and they abruptly stop at the midline. Here also intraorally, it is seen abruptly stopping at the midline. The lesions are in the form of vesiculobular eruptions which ulcerate and show the crusting on it. Intraorally also a similar picture is seen. Now what is important is there is a severe neuralgia which is associated with the disease. Because of the neuropathic effect the virus produces, and post-herpetic neuralgia is a common complication. The viruses, when they involve the geniculate ganglion, it is termed as Ramsey-Hunt syndrome. It involves the geniculate ganglion and so along with the oral lesions, there is facial paralysis and involvement of the ear. Because of involvement of the ear, there are blisters on the external ear and the functioning also is affected. This is facial paralysis which is seen and these are the oral lesions. Histopathology, there is ballooning degeneration of the cells which is seen in the, which are seen in the vesicle, intraepithelial vesicles. There are intranuclear inclusion bodies called as Lipschitz bodies. The multinucleated giant cells are also seen. Lab diagnosis is on the clinical features, Zhang test, the viral culture may be done and detection of antibodies can be done against these viruses. Now what are inclusion bodies? Inclusion bodies are nuclear or cytoplasmic aggregates of virions or collection of viral antigens or degenerative changes produced by the viral infection. And thus they represent the sites of viral replication or accumulation. They may be intracytoplasmic, nuclear or both. Now in case of herpes simplex and varicella zoster, what we see are intranuclear Lipschitz bodies. Another virus of the group is Epstein-Barr virus and it has a tropism for B lymphocytes. And it is a causative factor in the lesions, infectious mononucleosis, which produces a lymphoid hyperplasia, Burkitt's lymphoma, nasopharyngeal carcinoma, and it is also found to be associated with the AIDS lesion, that is B-cell lymphoma in AIDS, and hairy leukoplakia, which occurs on the lateral borders of the tongue in case of AIDS. Infectious mononucleosis, it's also called as glandular fever or kissing disease. Here it is characterized by cervical lymphadenopathy, pharyngitis, tonsillitis. The lesions, intraoral lesions, such as stomatitis and gingivitis, they may be in the form of petechiae, which occur on the soft palate and near junction of hard and soft palate. In addition, there is lymphoid hyperplasia, as seen here. The Paul Bunyan test is positive. Another group is Coxsackie group of viruses. This can produce hand, foot and mouth disease and herpangina. The herpangina lesions are characteristically seen as vesicular lesions occurring in the posterior part of the palate or in the oropharynx region, which may extend anteriorly into the oral cavity. Whereas in hand, foot and mouth disease, similar type of lesions are seen on the hand, mouth and on the feet, and it's more often seen in children. Now, some of the viruses, they can produce localized proliferative changes. And this is by human papilloma virus, that is focal epithelial hyperplasia or Hex disease. Such proliferative lesions can be seen in the oral cavity because of the virus, which give a cobblestone or fissured appearance to the mucosa. The human immunodeficiency virus, it's a retrovirus. It infects the CD4 T cells, thus affecting the immune system of the body. And because the immune system is affected, there are various infections associated with the HIV infection. Like very often it is candidiasis, it may, of different types. Then there is necrotizing gingivitis, necrotitis periodontitis, mycobacterium tuberculosis, necrotizing ulcerative stomatitis, various viral infections can occur. The aphthous stomatitis is also associated with this disease. And in addition to this, there are some lesions called Kaposi's sarcoma. Non-Hodgkin's lymphoma is also more commonly associated with AIDS. And these are the various other lesions which are found in association with acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. The diagnosis of the disease is done by demonstrating the antibodies in the serum. It is done by ELISA and Western blot. Western blot is a confirmatory test for the disease. The viruses, when they affect the salivary glands, it is the paramyxovirus, and it produces an acute, contagious, unilateral or bilateral swelling of the salivary glands, and it usually involves the parotid. When it involves the parotid, it lifts up the ear lobules. Characteristically, there is pain, the orifice of the gland in the oral cavity is swollen. It lasts for about 1 week and gets corrected. But the complications which are mentioned are orchitis and pancreatitis. There may be a raised serum amylase level in the disease. The viral exanthematous disease is measles, seen in children. It has the cutaneous rash, which is seen on the skin. In the oral cavity, these white spots are poplite spots. These are the table salt like crystals on an erythematous base. Histopathologically, the hyperplastic lymphoid tissue shows the Warthin-Fickled giant cells, which are characteristic of measles.